The Sword of Light! What has he done?
Almighty Yggdrasil, source of all life! Yield your power to me!
What's the matter, dearie? Can't you sleep?
No, Mum.
You're still upset about your little fight with Gemma, eh?
She started it. She hit me for no reason. All I did was draw eyebrows on Sandy. Oi, don't laugh. Look at this great big lunch she's given me.
I see it. And I saw the one on her head, too. You gave her that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Now you listen to me, my lad. There'll be plenty of times in your life when people upset you and you feel like lashing out. But no matter how much it hurts, and no matter how much you want to hurt them back, you don't go looking for revenge. You do what's right.
I want to be friends with Gemma again, Mum. What should I do?
Well, you talk to her, of course, you big silly. Ask her what she was feeling and why she did what she did. Try to see things from her point of view. Once you've done that, the rest is easy. You just smile and hold out your hand. That's my boy. Now, time for bed.
Night-night, Mum.
Night-night, son. Don't you worry about a thing now. It'll all be all right in the morning. Good night. Sleep tight, child of Yggdrasil. The sun, it is sleeping, and the night is still. The stars, they watch over you. with twinkling eyes, to ward off the darkness till dawn arrives.
Have you found him yet?
Not yet, Master. Our forces have scoured the four corners of the world, but the Luminary is nowhere to be found.
He is dead, then. Good, if that is the case. Then this world is mine.
Mordiggan has played his hand. The game is all but won. A shroud of deepest darkness has eclipsed the shining sun. And yet, amid the shadows, glimmer tiny specks of light. Faint, flickering flames that rage against the coming of the night. How can such sparks of hope remain when darkness rules the land? Now evil reigns supreme. Who has the strength to take a stand?
What happened? Where am I? I'm alive. But how?
Sylv! Oh, thank goodness you're all right. Sylv! Stay with me, Sylv! Come on, pull yourself.
Oh, there you are. You all right, Sylv?
Oh, sure, Davy, honey. I was just getting a little air. Being cooped up in that cabin was driving me crazy, you know?
Oh, come on, Sylv. Cheer up, will ya? I don't think I can take much more of this moping.
That day, when Mordiggan... there was nothing I could do. He was just too powerful. I thought it was the end for me. For all of us. But this is worse than death. To wake up and find everybody gone. And the world consumed by darkness. I'm sorry, Davy. But I can't do this. I know I should feel lucky to be alive, but without the others, I'm nothing. Nobody.
Right. That's enough of that.
Huh?
Have you lost your bleeding marbles? Since when were them mates of yours the types to let some Lord of Shadows numpty get the better of them, eh? How about you have a bit of bleeding faith in them like you used to? Or did you think saving the world was going to be easy or something?
Oh, Davy, darling. You're right. If a slip of a thing like me was able to get out of that tangle with Mordagon alive, then the others must have done too. And here I am feeling sorry for myself instead of getting out there and trying to find them. What would Veronica and Eric say if they saw me like this?
That's more bleeding like it. It's good to have you back, me old mucker.
Oh, it's good to be back, believe me. Now, enough chit-chat. It's time for action. We need to make land at the nearest port and find out just how much of a mess the world is in. And once we've done that, we can make a start on fixing it.
Sounds like a plan, Sylv. Nearest harbor to here would be over in Gondolia. I'll plot a course right away.
That sounds just perfect, honey. Anchors away! Hoist the mainsail! Gondolia, here we come!
Aye, aye, Captain. What? Watcher?
way! Day? Hmm? Don't worry, honey. It happens to us all.
Hmm? Oh. You're one of those minstrel types, are you? Look, if it's money you want, you'd better go and hassle someone else. I haven't got a penny to give you.
Sorry, darling. No can do. It's against my policy to leave people all alone when they look as down in the dumps as you do. Look, why don't you just tell me what's on your mind? A problem shared is a problem halved. That's better. Now we can talk properly. Silvando, entertainer extraordinaire at your service.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, my name's Tetsu. I'm a blacksmith from Hotto, though I haven't been back in a long old while. I'll tell you my story if you really want, but I'm warning you, it doesn't have a happy ending. After all those years away, I thought it was time for me to finally head home, see how my mother was doing, you know. But then the minute I set out on my journey, Yggdrasil fell. That just made me even more desperate to get back, of course. I was so worried about her. I managed to make it as far as Gondolia, but then my luck finally ran out. My luggage was stolen by a gang of thieves who've been terrorizing the town. The Beastly Boys, they call themselves. I can't make the journey to Hotto without all my things. Especially not the lilies of the valley I bought for my mother. They're her favorite flower. I wanted to give them to her to say, well, to say sorry for being away for so long. For leaving her all alone.
Oh, honey, believe me, I know exactly how you feel. Fear not, friend. Your mother will get her flowers. Dave and I will make sure of that. All you need to do is tell us where we can find these beastly boys.
Oh, well, if you're sure. There are two merchants, brothers, who run establishments in the southern part of town. I've heard that the beastly boys have been hanging around causing trouble at the older one's stall.
A stall in the south of town, huh? All right, we'll be back before you know it. Dave, darling, let's roll.
Wait. Look, I appreciate you trying to help me, but these are real thugs we're talking about here. And no offense, but you're just an entertainer, right? I wouldn't want you getting hurt.
Oh, don't you worry about me, sweetie. I'm more than just a pretty face, you know?
Boys. Take this! I'm on fire!
Damage up!
We did it, darlings!
Now, if you don't mind...
What we gonna do with this horrible lot then, Sylv?
Well, beastly they may be, but they're not exactly the dangerous thugs we heard about. They can barely swing a sword. What's your story, boys, huh?
We didn't start out as criminals. We were fishermen. And very happy fishermen at that. But after Yggdrasil fell, we couldn't take the boats out anymore. Have you seen the sea lately? It's swarming with monsters.
Things were just impossible. Most days, we barely had anything to eat.
The world might as well have ended that day. Lost our families. Lost everything. And no one came to help us. So we had to choose between a life of crime or starving to death. And that's no choice at all.
Watch closely, darlings. This is just an ordinary steel pike, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Think again! From arms to... Who's for fresh bread, huh? Bon appetit, beastly boys! Eat your fill and forget your wicked ways. You'll be beaming again before you know it.
Wait! Who? Who are you?
Me? Oh, nobody. Just someone who likes to see people smile.
Still in one piece. Now I can go home to my mother with my head held high. Thank you, Mr. Silvando. Oh, here. It's not much, but I want you to have these.
Oh, Tetsu, darling. Whatever they are, I'm sure they're wonderful. You're such a sweetie.
Honestly, you deserve much more. Come and visit me in Hotto sometime. I'll be able to thank you properly. Now, I'd better be off. I'd tell you to be careful, but I've got a feeling you'll be just fine. Bye for now.
Ta-da! Yeah, you all right, Sylv?
Oh, I'm better than all right, darling. I found it. My purpose in life. My raison d'etre. You know how I've been so down in the dumps thinking about all the despair and suffering in the world? Well, if that's what's making me so unhappy, there's only one thing to do about it. Get out there and fix the problem. Help make people happy again. Just because I can't save the world with some grand heroic gesture, that doesn't mean I can't do it one smile at a time.
That's my Sylve. I'm with you all the way.
We heard everything you just said.
It's them tea leaves from before. I hope they ain't spoiling for another fight. Didn't they learn a lesson first time round?
You have to let us come with you. You have to let us help people. We're done with our life of crime, thanks to you.
You want to tag along? Well, I hope you understand it won't be easy. I can't guarantee you'll get home in one piece.
We don't care!
Well, in that case, welcome aboard, darlings.
Yes!
Now, as luck would have it, I've got you all a welcome gift. Here, take one each now. Don't be greedy.
Wow.
Oh, they're simply fabulous. Darlings, you look splendid.
I don't get it, Sylve. What are they?
They're the presents dear old Tetsu gave us. If we're going to be traveling around spreading happiness and laughter, we'll need to look the part, no? All right, we're all set. Let's get out there and bring some sunshine back into the world. Sylvando's super special smile-spreading parade starts right here!
Yeah!
Take this! Huh. Is that all you...
Thank you.
hot stuff coming through!
Leave it to me!
Damn it, Chop!